Wealth, money, and prosperity, these are the dreams everyone aspires to, yet achieved by few. Today, let's talk about your relationship with money. Okay with you? So I'll start by asking you a question, and I want you to be honest, all right? Have you ever wondered why some people manage to become rich while others continue to struggle with debts and expenses year after year? Have you noticed something? Why does school teach us things we'll never use in life, but never teach us about money? Why does it have to be like that? If school taught you about money, perhaps you'd already be rich today. But if school didn't teach you, I will. Because what you've never learned about money in your entire life, you'll learn in this short video. Get ready for a journey of discovery, where we'll reveal secrets about how money really works, far beyond just saving and investing. Let's dive into the world of personal finance, entrepreneurship, and much more. Are you ready to change the way you think about money? Let's start with simple things. Is money good or bad? We've been taught that money is something bad. You need to rethink your beliefs about money. Often in movies, the rich are portrayed as dishonest cheats, and you might think, I don't want to be dishonest or a cheat, so I'll remain poor. However, money can't be good or bad. People are good or bad with money. Money simply amplifies their options. I can use a sum of money to do illicit things, but I can also use that same money to buy food for the homeless. In this case, money is just a facilitator in our lives, but we determine the options. How many times have you heard that the rich don't enter heaven? I've heard it many times myself, so you might think, if the rich don't enter heaven, then I want to be poor, right? We need to rethink our beliefs because most rich people are hardworking and honest. That's why many people trust them because they are trustworthy. Would you trust doing business with dishonest people? Definitely not. So why do you think others would? People trust the rich because they're trustworthy. Of course, there are dishonest rich people too, many who earn fortunes illegally, but I want you to understand that most aren't like that. When the media finds a dishonest rich person, they talk about it all the time, until we get the impression that all the rich are dishonest, which isn't true. So say it like this, I will be an honest rich person. I've met honest and dishonest rich people, as well as honest and dishonest poor people. So rethink this situation. Because you'll never become something you despise. If you despise the rich, you'll probably never become one. So how about changing that perspective? The other question is whether the rich go to heaven or not. Let me tell you something. The Creator created all things. All the wealth in this world belongs to Him. For God Himself says, "The silver and gold are all mine." Now I ask you, how can a God who owns everything want His children to suffer? We need to reform our thoughts about this because the God of the Bible is an abundant God in grace, love, mercy, and His desire is for His children to prosper too. Now I need you to understand something very serious. Money needs to be in your bank account or in your pocket, but never in your heart, right? Repeat after me, your money needs to be in your pocket or in your bank account and never in your heart. When used for good, money can even facilitate your spirituality because you can use your money abundantly to help your needy brother. Some people are so mediocre in this that when they pray, they ask God only for their daily bread. So I ask you, if God needs you to feed a homeless person, what do? Since you only ask for yourself, if God wants you to financially bless a missionary on a mission on another continent, what do? You only think of yourself. Only ask for yourself. Are you individualistic? No, you're not individualistic. You just have a mistaken thought about money that needs to be corrected. When you pray, ask God to greatly bless your financial life so that you can live well and bless others too. So we've already dispelled two big myths. The myth that every rich person is dishonest and the myth that the rich don't enter heaven. Can we continue? If you understand, comment like this, I understand. Now learn a great lesson about money. Money doesn't accept disrespect. It's an excellent servant, but a terrible master. Learn to master it, or it will master you. Know how to intentionally control everything that comes in and goes out of your life in terms of money. Know exactly how much you owe each month in fixed bills and try to reduce any cost that doesn't make sense. There's something called a credit card, which is the terror of many families because people think the credit card balance is an extension of their salary. But no, my friends, it's not. Understand this. If you spend all your credit card balance and these expenses exceed the value of your monthly salary, congratulations, you've just harmed your finances and it can cost you dearly. Every time you use a credit card, think, do I really need what I'm buying? If you ask yourself and really think about it, you'll realize that most of the things you buy with a credit card, most of the time you don't need. Because I've never known anyone who got into debt with a credit card because they needed to buy groceries for the month. But I've seen many people who got into debt buying a new phone, a new TV, new clothes, and in the end, they didn't need any of it. They just bought it on impulse. Some people are consumers by nature, have a habit of spending recklessly, and this needs to be corrected if you want to be rich someday. But if you want to remain poor, you don't need to change anything. That's the path. I don't know about the rest of the world, but here in Brazil, we usually say that the credit card is a quick fix. A quick fix is a popular saying we use when something made our lives easier in a particular situation. For example, my car broke down and my friend gave me a ride. In this case, my friend did me a favor. Yes, many people use the credit card as a quick fix, but be careful, my friends, because this favor it does today is the same favor it will use to hit you on the head later. Our financial life has four levels. I'll explain each one and you'll see where you fit, okay? The first level is the worst of all. The person receives the salary of the month, and when they do the math, they realize they spent more than they earned. The numbers never add up. They earn 2,000 and spend 2,500. I imagine the person in this situation can hardly sleep at night. It's lamentable. It destroys families. I've seen countless relationships that ended not for lack of love, but because of numerous arguments arising from lack of money. Let's take our finances more seriously. The second financial level is spending everything you earn. The person receives their salary, manages to pay all their debts, but nothing is left, not even for an ice cream. The person can pay all debts, but nothing is left. This financial model also needs to be corrected as soon as possible because this person isn't living. They're just surviving, agree? The third level is a bit better. The person receives the salary, manages to pay all the month's debts, manages to save some money, but the money saved, they don't know what to do with it. So they end up wasting this surplus on useless things, or sometimes leave this money in savings, and this money is being devalued every day because of inflation. The fourth financial level is what I recommend to everyone. The person receives their salary, manages to pay all bills, saves some money, and this surplus serves as a multiplier. In my case, some years ago, before becoming a millionaire, I took the surplus from my salary and bought products to resell, bought for 50 and sold for 100, and thus I made my money multiply. I made my surplus multiply through entrepreneurship. But if you don't know how to be an entrepreneur, you need to know how to invest to operate your financial life at level 4. First, make sure you have money left over, then make it multiply. Take your surplus and buy stocks with potential for appreciation. Buy real estate funds. These are variable income assets. The profit here is higher, but there are more risks, or invest in something less risky. But with less profit is better than none. In this case, you could invest in treasury bonds, for example. Search on YouTube later about how to invest your money wisely. The investment needs to have three things. It needs to be safe, profitable, and have liquidity. Now let's talk a little about money. Money has five levels. Don't confuse it with financial levels. Financial levels are four, which we just talked about. Now let's talk about the five levels of money. So subscribe to the channel to not miss future videos. It doesn't make sense for you to be watching this video until now without subscribing to the channel. If you're still watching, it's because it's making sense to you, and it will make even more sense if you subscribe. When it comes to money, consider these five levels. The first level of money is earning. This is non-negotiable. Find a way to earn money, so the first level is earning. The second level is investing. Got some money? Set aside a portion of that money to invest, right? Because this will make your money grow over time. Invest, even if it's the minimum. For example, received 100, invest 10. Received 200, invest 20, and so on. So the second level of money is investing. Got some money? Take some of it out to invest. The third level of money is saving. When considering spending, ask yourself, do I really need this item? Most of the time, you'll find that you don't. If you decide not to spend on frivolous things, then you'll be saving money. I want you to understand that I don't want you to be stingy or deprive yourself of things you enjoy eating. That's not what I'm teaching here. Sometimes you'll feel like eating a pizza, so go ahead, because you deserve it. But if you're buying a new pair of shoes, and you know you already have 150 pairs of shoes in the drawer, then save your money, as it would be an unnecessary expense. After all, you're not a caterpillar. You only have 2 feet. The fourth level of money is keeping. Set aside part of your money, like personal tithing, because the money you save will be a magnet that attracts even more money, as money attracts money. For example, when you turn on the tap in your house, the water flows down and goes to the river. The river flows into the sea, so water goes where there is water. And hatred goes to those who hate, and love goes to those who love, and money goes to those who have money. And when you do personal tithing, you're saying, I have money. Then even more money will come into your life. This money you'll leave stored in an account just to attract more money. But you might think, I earn little money, and if I do this, nothing will be left. So if you already earn little, 10% is almost nothing, you can do it. There are people around the world who live on much less than you and live well. The fifth level of money is spending. Here you pay your debts and buy what you like. But notice that money has 5 levels. Most people don't make money go through these 5 levels. The money that many earn only passes through the first and last level, which is earning and spending, earning and spending. If it's only like this, you'll hardly get anywhere. Let's talk about receiving money. How do you receive your money? In the form of salary or in the form of profit? And let me tell you something. Most people receive a salary, but profit is better than salary. If you accept to work for someone in exchange for a salary, you're putting an end to the chances you have of earning more money. Because the salary is payment for hours worked. Like your hours are limited, just like everyone else's, when your hours worked end, the chances of you earning more money also end. So it's preferable to work for profit, not for salary. For example, when you sell a product, you make a profit. Products can be unlimited, unlike your time. Many people say, I don't like selling. But the truth is that we're all sellers. We're all selling something. If you're an employee, in this case, you're selling your time. If someone is willing to pay for your time, it's because they're earning much more for your service. Now imagine if you use that time to work on something that's yours. Be passionate about sales. Sales are the best business in the world. Avoid selling your time, because time is the most scarce asset that humans have. Once wasted, you can't recover it. And many people spend their whole lives working for a salary, and that amount isn't even that high. People stop working on something for themselves, to work for others. That's why you need to work on something that's yours. Because if you don't work hard to achieve your dreams, someone will hire you to achieve their dreams, and in return, they'll give you a salary, while they keep all the profit. To attract wealth into your life, you need to learn to work with giving and receiving. There are people who are great givers, but terrible receivers. They're too proud to receive something from someone. And there are also people who are great receivers, but terrible givers. They're mediocre people. So learn to work with giving and receiving. Giving and receiving is like a wheel, and you know that a half wheel doesn't turn, right? So for this wheel of wealth to turn in your life, it has to be complete. You need to learn to work with giving, because giving will work as a multiplier in your life. Look at the gardener. He prunes the trees so they produce more flowers and fruits. Sometimes it's necessary to prune the money tree too, so it produces more fruits. Giving has two faces. When you give to those in need, you're being charitable. Now, if you buy a gift for your friend and he could very well buy that gift himself, then you're being generous. The interesting thing is to do both, give to those in need and also to those who don't need. Because if you only give to those in need, you're training your brain the wrong way. Your unconscious brain will be programmed as follows. In order to receive, I need to be in need. Now, when you give to those who don't need it, you're telling your subconscious, I receive even when I don't need it. You learned how to work with giving. Now you need to learn how to work with receiving. When someone offers you something, accept it. Because when a person does a good deed, dopamine is released in their brain and they'll be happy. If someone offers you something and you don't accept it, you're stealing someone's happiness. So for money to flow well in your life, make the wheel of wealth spin faster. Always work with giving and receiving. The world is always evolving. What do you work with today? There was a time when people worked in crop fields because that's what was available. At that time, those who owned property and the most servants, they were the ones who ruled the world. As the world is always evolving, the era of the Industrial Revolution arrived. Then the rural exodus effect occurred, which is the departure of people from the countryside to the city. They stopped working in the fields to work in companies with machines. During this time of the Industrial Revolution, those who had more money ruled the world. As the world is always evolving, now we're in the digital revolution. In 1996, Bill Gates said, "In the future, there will be two types of companies, those that will do business on the internet and those that will be out of business." And believe it or not, that time is already here. The future Gates talked about has arrived. Look at your credit card. How many purchases have you made online in the last few months? Look how many meals you've ordered through apps. People ride in cars through apps. So the world today is digital. If people or companies aren't on the internet today, unfortunately, they're outdated. In the rural era, those who had land ruled. In the Industrial Revolution, those who had money ruled. In the Digital Revolution, those who have information rule. Notice that the valuable currency is always changing. The valuable currency today is information. It's worth more than gold. The digital era doesn't require you to be talented, doesn't require you to have diplomas. The internet is available to anyone who wants to enter, both as a spectator and as a producer. And the entry barrier is minimal. Sometimes a person only needs a cell phone to start creating digital content and make a lot of money. Today, what gives more money is being a digital content creator. The teacher who earns the most money is the teacher who creates digital content. The doctor who earns the most money is the doctor who creates content for the internet. And there's room for you too, if you want. In my case, I'm not a doctor and I'm not talented, but I have a lot of knowledge about creating digital content. I've been doing this since 2021. I've made a few million through the internet. And today I create content without needing to appear and without using my voice. This voice you're hearing isn't mine. It's a voice generated by artificial intelligence, but the text is 100% mine. I typed every word you're hearing, including these words I'm typing now. If you want to learn from me how to create these types of videos, I left a link in the description, then you click. Many people say, I don't make money because I don't have a good education. I'm not a doctor. I'm not a lawyer. I didn't manage to graduate from college. And now, well, I see you still don't understand nowadays. To make money, it's not about that. Nowadays, you can manufacture nails and make more money than many doctors together because you'll earn for the value you generate for a person or companies. Let me exemplify. Imagine you manufacture nails to sell. You can sell nails to various stores that sell building materials, and you can even sell your goods online, even when you're sleeping. While a doctor can attend to one person at a time, you can attend to several people at once through online stores. But I know you don't manufacture nails. Let's go to another example then. Why does a digital influencer sometimes earn in a month an amount that a doctor won't earn in their entire life? Let's explain now. And everything I'm teaching you is for you to apply in your life somehow. Imagine I'm a digital influencer and I have 3 million followers. Of course, some influencers have more than that. A very famous bag brand decided to hire me to promote their products in a 60-minute live stream, and during the live stream, only 1% of my followers decided to buy. So 30,000 people bought a bag on sale that costs 3,000. But during my live stream, I got a discount coupon, and for my followers, each bag would cost 900. So the conclusion was as follows: 30,000 people spent 900 each. So I generated for the company that made the bags 27 million in 60 minutes. So it's fair that they pay me at least 1 million. Do you agree? Meanwhile, the doctor who charges 300 for each consultation in 60 minutes will be able to attend to at most 3 people. So he'll earn 900 in 60 minutes, and in the same time, I can earn 1 million being a simple influencer. Do you see the impact that the internet can cause? While a doctor can impact the lives of a few people working from an office, an influencer can impact the lives of thousands of people and even millions. That's why I say the best business today is to work through the internet, because you can impact many people with a global reach. People will pay you according to the value you generate. If you generate value for a few people at a time, you'll receive little. If you can impact the lives of thousands of people at a time, you'll earn thousands of dollars. If you can impact the lives of millions of people, you'll get millions of dollars. And that's the new game. Instead of lamenting, learn to play and play. There's room for you too. That's why Amazon, Facebook, YouTube earn billions a month, because they impact the lives of billions of people. I know you couldn't create the new Amazon, but you can be a digital content creator and thus impact the lives of millions of people through your content. I have much more to share with you, but if I continue, the video will be too long. So I can do part 2 if you want me to. Comment like this: liked the video and want part 2. If you comment I can do it, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and share this content with family and friends, because good things should be shared. Now there are 2 videos appearing on your screen that I prepared with great care. These videos are full of knowledge that will add great value to your financial life. Click on one of them and go watch it. Now,